Welcome to Overdrive Basics Part 2. Once again, I'm Cassie, one of the reference librarians here at Westerly Library in Wilcox Park. Today we're going to look at how to browse for materials, how to use filters to narrow down your results, and a few of the things that you can control through your account settings. If you are brand new to Overdrive, I would recommend watching our first video titled Overdrive Basics Part 1. So you'll see here that I'm already signed into my Overdrive account. In the last video, I had mentioned the different options for browsing for materials, so we're going to look at this in a bit more detail. If you go to the Subjects link on the left-hand side and click on that, you'll be brought to a new page where you can choose to search for just ebooks, audiobooks, or movies on specific subjects of your choice. This is great if you are a fan of a certain genre, for example, historical fiction, or if you're looking for something on a very specific subject, such as architecture. If you click on one of these links, it'll show you all of the materials in our Overdrive collection that are listed under that subject heading. The Collections tab is another great option if you're just looking to browse. You can choose to browse for just ebooks or audiobooks, look at the most popular items in each format, choose to view only those items that are currently available, and much, much more. If you are using a Kindle, it's important to know that not all ebooks in Overdrive are compatible with your device. To make sure that you are only seeing books that'll work with your Kindle, you can click here on Kindle Books. Whenever you browse the collection or search for a title or author, you will see options to narrow down your results on the left-hand side of the page. This is also called filtering results. So let's look at an example. Say I decide to browse by the most popular ebooks. Click on here. As you see, I have more than 1,000 results that fall under that category. The filters allow me to narrow this down to what I'm really looking for. If I don't want to wait for an ebook, for example, I can click on Available Now to see only the ones that are available to be checked out at this moment. And we see this immediately will limit it to less than 300 results, which is much better. I can also narrow by subject, such as if I'm looking for mystery. And we see now that I have only 81 results that are relevant to me. The last thing we're going to look at today is your account settings. If you click here on the top right, My Account, and then Settings under the drop-down menu, it'll give you various settings that you can control. One of the things you can do is adjust your default lending period for different materials. When you check out a title, you can always adjust this. You can also choose what kind of content you want to see. If your child is using Overdrive, for example, you might want to limit it to just juvenile materials. Those will be the results they see when they do a search. On the other hand, if you are an adult and you don't want to see children's materials, you can choose to just limit it to general adult, mature adult, or even both of them. Some of the accessibility features include a high contrast mode for those visually impaired users, as well as a dyslexic font, which will make it easier to read for those with dyslexia. If you're using a Kindle or another device to read books, there are even more options available. And now we're at the end of the tutorial. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you're now more comfortable using Overdrive on your computer. As always, please reach out to a member of the staff if you need additional assistance.